Greetings, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Narsgel, creator of the UMC mods for HoI4, and I welcome you to this modding tutorial for total beginners. This modding tutorial series will be divided into 7 videos. First one serves as an introduction, and you will see on the next slide what awaits us in this video. In the second one we will talk about focuses, third one will be about ideas or national spirits, fourth will be about events, fifth about decisions, and sixth about localization. You can of course, after seeing video number 2, jump to the video number 6 and learn about localization if you want to. And the seventh video will be like a sum up, where we will recap some things and also talk about phase 2 of the modding tutorial series. In that we can learn some more advanced things if you are interested. Now taking a look on what will be in this video, there will be some introduction, I will tell you some rules about modding, what program to use for modding, we will learn how to use debug mode, we will create our new mod, we will put our first files into our mod, for that I have prepared a starter pack, which I will tell you more about in a minute, and I will explain differences between mod files and vanilla files for HoI4. So who am I? Well, as I said, I'm Narsgel, creator of the UMC mods. You can find them on the Steam Workshop. I'm currently preparing to release UMC 2.0. Now, why am I creating this tutorial? Because there are definitely some tutorials already on the YouTube, but in my opinion, they are not exactly suited for the total beginners. They were also created like few years back, so something might have changed, and therefore I am creating this tutorial. I am also looking for more modders to join UMC, and this tutorial will help me to guide them if they want to learn how to mod. And well, we have already talked about the other 2 points, so just if you have any question or want to contact me or want to get that starter pack, you should join the UMC Discord. I'll put the link in the description. Also, the starter pack sounds like something you would have to pay for, but no, it's free. It's just on my Discord, so you can go there and get it. You will see what it does in a minute. It really helps you to get on with your modding. I myself I'm using that starter pack when I'm creating new mods. So, I will tell you some rules of modding and then I will be gone, at least from the monitor, and we will get to some actual modding. So, first rule is that modding is easy. Really, when you first look at it, it might seem like it's something hard, but that's only because you don't know where to start, you know? You just have to give it like, I don't know, 5 hours. And it will seem easy to you as well. And the modding is easy because it's 90% in 90% cases just copy and pasting. Because, you know, you are not programming some new websites or something. You are just creating something to the game. And most of the time what you want to create, someone already created. So for the beginners, I suggest that when you want to do, for example, some focus, you take a look on vanilla files, how Paradox did that focused, probably in some similar way, and you just copy that code from that focus to your own. And well, when we are a bit advanced, then you can like create your own focuses, but then again, you are just copy-pasting some commands, some modifiers from Wiki or from other focuses. Third rule, never edit vanilla files, we will explain difference between mod files and vanilla files in a minute. Just know that if you edit vanilla files, oftentimes you have to reinstall the game. Fourth rule is what is opened must be closed. That rule is for when you will be modding, you will be using a lot of brackets. And when you are using brackets, you open something and then you have to close it with this special bracket again. If you don't close it, your code will be broken, and well, it's like, you know, one of the most often cases of like coding error. Again, it will make more sense when we are actually coding or modding. Fifth rule is that you always should use the debug mode when we are modding, because it makes your modding life much easier. Sixth rule is that what's behind this magical symbol doesn't count. Again, we'll explain more when we are modding. That will be all from my face, and let's get to work. So, what program to use for modding? I personally use Notepad++. You can get it for free and it works just fine. You can however use like any program that allows you to modify your notes. Again, we'll put a link for download to the description. Point 4, the debug mode. Alright, so to enable debug mode, you will go to your Steam, Hearts of Iron 4, click Properties, and then General, and here put .debug. Now I will show you a few things what debug does. Having debug enabled does a lot of things. For example, the error log shows you here, which tells you about all your problems in the game. You can also, for example, if you are on the state with your mouse, you can do Ctrl+Alt and see some more information about that state, which is really helpful. If you open your focus tree, you will see that every focus now shows focus ID, which is again very helpful. And perhaps the main thing it does is that when you change your focus tree through modding, it will immediately put that change in the game. Therefore, you don't have to do it through the console commands. Like this. So, as I said, always use the debug mode when you are modding. Now, point 5, creating your new mod. Finally, let's do it. To create your mod, you start Hearts of Iron 4, go to All Installed Mods, Upload Mod, and create a mod. Now, here name is what will people see on the Steam Workshop when you upload it. Version is just something like for you, so you can put, for example, 1, because it's first version of our mod. And the directory will create a new folder. So let's get name AFK modding tutorial, for example, and here AFK modding tutorial. And the text tells you what your mod is focused on. So we will get national focuses, events, that'll be fine, and create a new mod. And our mod has been created. Before we take a look on where it is, we will have to enable it. So you have your playsets here, you can see I have 4, and if we take a look on playsets here, this is my playset nothing, I will use this nothing for the modding tutorial. You can see that we have one new mod, we will click add to the current playset, and we have it here. You can also add it to the playset manually if you go here, add more mods, and select it through here. Now, if you have it enabled here in your playset, and you select this playset and start a game, you will have that mod active. Now let's go to the point 6 and put some files into our mod and also find it. I will explain both of these points together because that will make the most sense. So firstly, the official like vanilla Hearts of Iron 4 is located under Steam. I have it here. Here, Steam. Then Steam Apps, Common, Hearts of Iron 4. These are all the files of the vanilla Hearts of Iron 4. Now to find our mod files, we will go to our computer again, to the Documents, Paradox Interactive, Hearts of Iron 4, and here you go to Mod. And here you can see all your mods, your own mods, and our the modding tutorial mod is here. And as you can see, it's empty currently. I will now explain how to put files into your mod. For that I have opened official Hearts of Iron 4 vanilla files on another tab. So, if you want to put any files into your mod, it needs to follow the exact same organization as it is in the vanilla files. From the vanilla files you will be most of the time using this folder common, and then events, and then localization. So if you want to, for example, put like focus tree into your mod, you will go to the common, national focus, and here all of the focuses that are currently in the game are listed. But you can't just like put this file and put it here. No. You have to create the exact same folders as they are in the vanilla files. So you can see that it's Hearts of Iron 4, common, national focus, and here are the focuses. So if you want to put this file into your mod file to modify it, you need to create common, the exact same folder, and here national focus as it is here. And only then you can copy certain focus into it. If you want to, for example, modify some national spirits or ideas, you will go to the common ideas and you can select which one you want to modify. But before that, again, you have to have common folder and in it ideas folder. And you can put your ideas here. To make your life much easier, I've created this starter pack. When we take a look, you will see that it already contains all the most important folders. That will save you a lot of time creating it. And it will be also much easier to navigate through them. Because, you know, it's easier to navigate through 4 folders than through, like, I don't know, 20. So, if you download the starter pack, all you will have to do is just copy those files and put them here. Now, when we take a look, you will see that in common we have national focus, national spirits, characters, decisions, country leaders, and, you know, other things here. When we take a look on, for example, the national focuses, you will see that there is already one file here. When you open it, you will see, oh, don't get scared, these are just my explanations, we will go through them in the next video, but you can see that I already prepared some things for you here. Another thing I would like to point out is how the files are working. For example, if you go to the focus, and let's put Czechoslovakia into our common national focus, same as here. If this file has the exact name as the one in the vanilla files, our file will overwrite the one in the vanilla files. But if you, for example, change it to, I don't know, this, this file won't overwrite this file. And it will cause a lot of problems because there will be duplicated IDs and so on and so on. What I oftentimes do is that I copy Czechoslovakia, the exact focus, then delete all of it and then use my own like name here, for example this. That way, the national focus of Czechoslovakia, basically, this empty file will override this file. Therefore, the game will think that this file is empty, the Czechoslovakian focus is empty, and you can continue doing changes in your like file. It's just something I use to better navigate through my focuses and files and so on. And with that, we are at the end of the first video. Well done, you have managed to create your own mod. Wasn't so hard, right? In the next video, we'll take a look on the focuses. And it will be probably more fun. Now, as I said, you can get the starter pack on UMC Discord. And if you want to, you can support me on my Patreon. See you in the next video. Bye!